The book that I'm at, how would you encourage other writers?
I think that my life should be an encouragement to other writers. I did not plan to have a writing career. I was terrified at the thought of trying to publish because of the rejection that was surely coming. And look what's happened. I mean, this is amazing. I'm sitting in this room with 2,000 people who are excited about my book. So if that doesn't encourage you, I don't know what will.
What is a good night's love going to be published?
Okay, I picked this one because I want you all to know that this may not happen right now. I have for the past 3 years been under deadlines. It's been rough. So I'm planning on sort of taking my time and writing when the spirit strikes. Now, it could mean that won't take very long at all. I wrote Twilight very quickly. But I don't want to make any promises. So I can't give exact dates on this, but when I have a workable rough draft and I have a better sense of how long, because the editing process is fairly standard, I'll be able to let you know when that's going to be.
Laura from Vancouver, Canada, has a bit of a role in another one about the host. In The Host, when Kyle met Sonny Jody, why did he not feel the hatred and resentment that Jared had felt towards Wanda?
See, that was just a really great specific Toast book. That makes sense. The reason is because he knew Wanda, and even though he reacted pretty negatively to her himself, it let him view Sonny in a whole different perspective. And so he wasn't able to have that negative reaction, because once you've been hanging out around his soul, it's kind of hard to see them the same way.
Jen W. from Canada asks, what kind of Ferrari does Bella drive?
Because really, can you drive anything other than F-430? Is there a Ferrari? I'm not aware.
I have no idea. I don't know. It's red.
Another one from up north, Vancouver, BC. If the werewolves stay werewolves for as long as there's danger in the realm of empires, will Jay remain a werewolf forever?
The vampires being around that triggers the change, but after that, as long as they fade into a werewolf fairly frequently, you know, I don't know, a couple times a month, then they don't age. They have to stop making and sleeping for the age to pick up again. So Jacob's pretty much good to go. He will not age.
Where's the blood?
So much blood.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.
Answer, please.
This was something that I always knew was going to be that way, and I did try to put a few clues into the manuscript. The mention of the Merchant of Venice was deliberate to foreshadow a battle of mind for the women's battle.
Yeah!
I am not the person. I don't think I have an ending to write the Hamlet ending.
Oh,
where, like, everything's bothering and there's one guy going, really got started, that there were not going to be very many people left standing on either side. And that, I wanted a win. I wanted a clear-cut win. And this is the way to do
it. Before Stephen, maybe.
Now, it's special when there's human lives who weren't such a superbly powerful vampire man.
That's a fun question. Okay, let's see. I'll try to get you involved. So, Alex and Jay, really, for all intents and purposes, in the Twilight universe, would be considered witches when they were human. You know, if you made Jay angry with you even as a small child, that just happened. It got funny, though. Errol was aware of the twins. He was very interested in acquiring them. So imagine his disapproval when the villagers decided to burn them at the stake. He interrupted that, and the village was no more. The being burned at the stake part sort of focused both their talents. Alex became all about no pain. That's what he was supposed to be. Whereas Jay learned to inflict that pain on others. So that's really how their talents developed. But they weren't talented before when they were human.
This one comes from Lisa. out of all of Carlisle's nomadic vampire friends, which one is your favorite and why?
Benjamin. Benjamin.
I really had fun kind of bringing in the vampire world with all the rings there. I really like Siobhan too. She's pretty cool. And then the Romanian. They're creepy in such a fascinating way.
Two more questions. This one's from Jessica. Were you sad when you made Bella a vampire? And do you miss, or did you miss, her human role?
One of the interesting things about the experience of writing about Bella as a vampire was that she really did lose some of her relatability for me, because at every point up until that point in the story, I could say, I could step into the story right here, and I can do everything she can do, which made it really this experience where you felt like you were part of the book, because you knew, I could do that. You know, I could do what Bella does. I could trip. So she explained to her. She wasn't like this super exotic person with magic power. She was just Bella. And I like that. I knew she was going to be a vampire. All along I've known that, by the way. And really get the sense of what that felt like. But at the same time, as I'm writing it, I couldn't step into the story anymore. I couldn't do that. And that made it a little bit harder. So I was kind of sad to see her lose that relatability, because she was a new and exciting Bella, but she wasn't a Bella I could be. And it was a little bit sad for me, but I wanted her to have that ending. It was important to me. So I was happy for her, but we just weren't as close as we had been before.
I understand.
Our last question of the night. Why did you choose to end the series after the fourth book?
I put that one right after the first one because the answer is the same. I knew that this wasn't going to be the same story with Bella the Vampire, and it wasn't going to be the same experience. So after her story was resolved in that way, I feel like it's told. There are series that can go on forever and ever, but I feel like it'd be really unnatural to prolong Bella's story that way, and I didn't want to ruin the story arc. You know, when a story goes the right direction, for me it's very visual, and I can see the shape of it. Every book has a different shape, and as a whole, these four books, this was the right shape for them. So it was the right place to end, and it doesn't mean that I'm done, because there are a whole lot of stories in my head, but this story has reached its natural conclusion, and I didn't want to ruin that.